Can they cover up? And in at the second time of asking, just what was required.
Well, here it is again, and I feel a bit sorry for the goalkeeper. He makes a good save to start with, but where are his defenders following in? Instead, it's the attacker who's alert. He gets to the ball first, and it's a good finish.
Palinha, Otavio, Bruno Fernandes, Otavio now, and Palinha with it,
and out for a throw-in, just misfiring with the pass.
Rabiot, Aurélien Tchouaméni, Dembélé, Tchouaméni. That is how to put in a challenge. He's been a bit unlucky to concede the corner. And they will make the change now. Can he put them in front?
Too close to the goalkeeper to really pose a threat.
Cleared away comprehensively. Rabiot.
Well, we're inside the final quarter of an hour now.
And foul it is then. Otavio.
Here's Ronaldo.
Silva. Trying to get onto the front foot with the minutes ticking away. Just wanted to get it out of there.
Well, trying his luck from a long way out, but the keeper saw it all the way.
João Cancelo. The ball with Otavio.
Well, adding up all the stoppages, we will have 3 extra minutes.
Well, it's a really poor challenge. Now, what's the referee going to do about it?
And they're making a change. Well, the referee not messing about. He's...
And that will be all for this game anyway. No goals to report. Defences on top. And Stuart, as ever, interested to get your take.
Well, Derek, I think it was a good tactical battle. There was a lot of endeavour, some good defending, but not enough attacking quality. And that's why we didn't get any goals.
Hello, great to have the pleasure of your company and welcome to our coverage of this semi-final here at the 2024 UEFA European Championship. My name is Derek Ray here in the commentary position and sitting next to me providing all the tactical analysis is Stuart Robson. Keen anticipation ahead of this colossal encounter. It's Spain versus France.
Well, semi-finals can be very nervous affairs, Derek, but this has the making of an absolute classic. 2 excellent teams, some great players, and 2 thoughtful coaches. This should be a very interesting tactical battle, I think.
Determined defending. Mikel Merino. Morata. Great opportunity. Great challenge, but they still could score. Oh, marvellous save. Great goalkeeping.
Lenormand.
Pedri. Mikel Merino. And scope for them to produce something exciting. Can't miss, surely. Misfiring completely.
Yeah, he's gone for power, but the contact was never right. It's a poor effort, really.
Konate. Well, nothing comes of it. Morata. And Torres on the ball.
Well, it's all about passing as they try to hit the front. Trying to find the right angle of attack. Oh, and it goes! The opening goal in this semi-final. A long way from being decided, but it could be telling.
Goal for the hosts, number 20.
And France get the ball moving again. Can they come up with an answer here? Plenty of support here. And let's give credit to the defending. And the pass was just that little bit off. Nearly found its target. Ibrahima Konate. And cleared away. And totalling up all the stoppages, we'll have 2 additional minutes. Oh, he's through here! Well, wasted opportunity here. Would have been a decent chance, but offside the verdict. And with that, the first half draws to a close. So the ball is rolling again. France trailing after the first half. Can they find an effective response here in the second? Giroud. Really looking comfortable with the ball at his feet as he runs, Olivier Giroud. Clear deflection off the defender there. Well, opting for the short corner. Mbappe. Well, mopping up defensively. And quick thinking to react to the situation and concede the throw. Ibrahima Konate. Griezmann. Dembele. Now Griezmann. Griezmann! Can they cover up? Well, let's find out if France can take advantage of this set piece. Now, how about the short corner? Rabiot. Well, another corner kick conceded. Let's see what they do this time. And the short option preferred. Lenormand. It's with Laporte. Pedri. The ball with Rodri. Mikel Merino. An alert intervention. Morata. Aurélien Tchouaméni. Dembélé. Now Giroud. This could level it. Well, he passed the power test. Shame about the accuracy. So a personnel change then. Lenormand. It's with Mikel Merino. It's with Oyarzabal. There might very well be late excitement. 5 minutes left and the margin just 1. Griezmann. They get forward, but time is very much against them here. This could be the equaliser. Oh, it's in! Can you believe it? Back on level terms, and the dream of making the final is very much alive again. Incredible!
Well, look at this again, because this is a really well-worked goal. The passing is incisive, the movement of the ball is bright, and it leads to a fairly simple finish in the end. It's a great goal.
Pedri. That is that after 90 minutes. They are level, and extra time is... Well, the ball rolling again. No end to the action. It's the first period of extra time, and I must say, this has been a back-and-forth type of game. France moving the ball forward. What can they do from here? Torres. Pedri. A big opportunity and a goal! How important could that be in the story of this semi-final? Wild celebrations! And they've been getting 2 substitutes warmed up, and both will come on here. Well, credit to him for the challenge, and a throw-in conceded.
Oyarzabal.
That'll be a Spain throw-in.
Dani Olmo.
And support available.
And a good take under duress there. Teo Hernandez.
Now Rabiot.
That's it. Half time in extra time. The second period still.
And away they go again. Second period of extra time has commenced. And continues his run.
Griezmann.
On to Rabiot. Rabiot.
Well, these fans have been brilliant. Just listen to them. Surely this will inspire the players to hang on here. What a noise we've got.
Koundé.
And full time here. Spain have done it. They've climbed the mountain and they will participate in the final itself here at the European Championship.
Well, it was certainly a tight contest for 90 minutes, but in extra time, that touch more quality came to the fore. And they...